Hello. I hope you're doing well. My name is Paul, in case you weren't already aware of that by now. And welcome to a very lighthearted, fun, laid-back, bare-bones ASMR video where it's just me, no pretense of anything except for the title, subject matter, which I'm going to hit on just a little bit throughout the video about trying to keep or restore your faith in humanity. All the while, I'm exploring a variety of different objects and things to help induce your ASMR, or if you don't experience ASMR, to help you relax after a long day of work or school or whatever the case might be. Maybe you're retired, you know. There's all kinds of people from all walks of life watching these videos for many different reasons. Or you're looking to sleep, whatever the occasion might be. All right, so there's a lot of different things. Some things you've seen. I'll be exploring some of our son's children's books and young readers' books. Even though some of you may not be able to relate to that, there's going to be some tapping sounds while I just kind of explore the books themselves. I'll be putting this lampshade over your head, so to speak, so you can enjoy some of the tapping sounds. And I have a variety of other things. You can easily look in the description of this video for the timeline of all the objects used. But first, you know, I thought we'd start off with a little drink and maybe a toast. Is that all right with you? I have some root beer. As you can see, it wasn't even opened until now. It's been sitting in our house now for a couple months. We bought it to make root beer floats, but as you can see, we really haven't made them. Makes for some really nice tapping sounds, though, at least. Let me just loosen up the bottle cap here. And listen to some bottle cap sounds. Now, if you ever happen to notice a lot of cuts in my videos, it's 99% of the time, it's me cutting out unwanted sounds, such as if I'm making too harsh of a sound when, you know, using a particular object, or like popping and cracking of our ductwork from a change in temperature, or my stomach trying to get in on the action. Alright, so let me pour you a drink first. that's one reason I chose the root beer for the fizz. I was going to do iced tea, but you don't get much of a fizz sound with that. Any particular color straw that you would like? No? Okay, I'll just grab you an orange one. Alright. You can have this one. I'll just keep it here on the table for whenever you want it. And I'll just grab a straw myself. Throughout the video, it's all about the sounds, the ice. I've always enjoyed these sounds as much as you or anyone else. When stirring next to your ear, since it can be quite harsh. There we go. Alrighty then. So, from me to you, here's to our health, here's to some peace of mind, and here's to keeping or restoring our faith in humanity. Cheers. Some calming hand motions. Just try and visually help you to relax. Calm your mind. Or get you kick-started off to dreamland, if that's where you're headed. finish up here. All right, so now you seem a little bit hungry, so I brought for you the bowl of infinite rice. So as long as you don't mind, feed you a little, give you a little rice, you can have some. There, you can listen to it real close. There you go. So, you know, keeping our faith in humanity, you know, and I'm not here to preach, but can be difficult day to day when you hear a lot of negative things happening in the world. Especially if you've experienced a lot of negative things yourself. I've been there. You know, I had my own personal experiences, and you know, things like that. There you go. But I think it's really important that try to keep in sight the fact that there are good people in the world. I know a lot of us, or a lot of people, you know, we get burned, and maybe sometimes we burn other people. You know, we're all human, right? We're all on both ends of that situation. And it's not always intentional. Sometimes it is. So, aside from the, you know, the personal experiences you have, stuff on a larger scale, like, political corruption and things like that, right? That's the last thing you want to hear about in an ASMR video, I'm sure. But let's need to bring it up, since that's really the topic. You know, people that want to harm others intentionally, you know, they're doing more than just, you know, a bad relationship or you know, making a mistake and saying something, you know, wrong. You know, there's some really, you know, we don't need to go through the whole list, but, you know, there's a lot of bad stuff in the world. And there you go. Enjoying the race so far? Great. Just one more. Speaking of food, I have a happy little potato. I rescued this cute guy from one of those, you know, vegetable fruit slavers. You know, they call themselves a supermarket, but you and I know better. So he's happy now, and he's gonna become my pet potato. And I'm going to try to get around to doing that how to keep a pet potato video. So how about just a little potato tapping? So there are a lot of good people in the world. There's a lot of people that just live a simple life. They go about their business. They work. They go to school. You know, they come home. Keep to themselves. You just don't ever hear about them, you know. They're just trying to survive. Could be you. Living a, you know, ordinary life. Nothing wrong with that. You know, when they say less is more, sometimes that's true. You know? And they're good people because they're, you know, they might be productive members of the society. Maybe not. Maybe they have a hardship. Maybe they can't work for whatever reason, but they're not, you know, making any trouble. So in that regard, they're what I like to say, good people. So you have everyday folks, you know, like us, just doing our thing, going about our lives. And then you have the people who are going a little above and beyond. You know, you have teachers, doctors, police, the folks in the military, the armed services, armed forces, volunteer firefighters, folks volunteering at shelters, homeless shelters or shelters for abused women, you know, things like that. So, I think it's important to try to maintain perspective when we're inundated, oftentimes, with negativity from the media, you know, online, on the internet, wherever it might be. And then you go outside and you realize it's not really that bad. I mean, I've been on this planet for 40-some years, and yeah, I've had some rough patches, but I'm still here. You know, I'm very lucky. And even though I'm not a man of faith, I'm blessed, you know, to be here. Very lucky, you know. Yeah. Something I try to take for granted. And then you realize, you know, with all that negativity, and the violence in the world, there are good people out there. You just don't hear from them because they're just going about their day. They're not making the headlines. So when you feel yourself, when you feel like there's so much negativity in the world, just try to remember, try to keep perspective that that's not the entire world. There's probably more good people in the world than there are not. And, you know, it's just something, this is what I try to do, you know. I hope you enjoyed that. I also have a jar of pickles. I love pickles. I love drinking the pickle juice. It's probably terrible for you, but... So I just... I'm not going to harp on that subject throughout the entire course of this video unless something pops in my head. I'm not here to preach. I'm not here to give advice. This is just me being me, trying to share how I cope or deal with negativity in the world. That's not the entire world. There's, like I said, a lot of good people out there. Now, we seem to focus on the negativity a lot, which is good in a way, because there are things that we need to address. But sometimes it just seems like it's every day. You know, there are people out there that take care of children and adults who have severe forms of autism. There are teachers trying to make impact, who are trying to help kids or, you know, adults. So and this is probably something that you already are aware of and know. You know, maybe I'm preaching to the choir, but and this is not coming off the heels of anything. But there are just, you know, moments throughout our lives, day to day, year to year, where things happen in the world that make us, make me at least, sometimes wonder, what kind of crazy world is this that we live in, you know? But then you realize it's not everyone, you know? And we've made progress as a species. We've come a long way. I mean, our current state, our human evolutionary state, this modern human, evolved 600,000 years ago. So it took us 600,000 years to get to where we are today. And it's only in the recent past, the last 1,000 years, the last few hundred years, where we made tremendous amounts of progress in terms of how we treat one another. I mean, here in the United States, we had slaves, and we've had white people, although I'm sure it may have been more than just white people, but white people fight to end slavery. They gave up their lives. So, it's not all gloom and doom. And that's really all I wanted to say. Do you mind if I reach into the pickle jar and steal a pickle? Would you want one? You can have one if you like. Oh, you'll pass? Okay. Smell that. Oh, delicious. I'm just going to steal one, okay? These are the old-fashioned sweet bread and butter chips. I've always loved these. I like dill pickers. I like dill pickles too, but I love sweet bread and butter. Here you go. Listen to some pickle jar bottle cap or jar cap. I wonder what the difference is between a bottle and a jar. Does that have something to do with the size? The type of lid? These are important things to know. Questions that we need to know the answers to. Now, I do want to say one last thing about people who aren't good people. And I'm not trying to throw anyone under the bus, but sometimes those questionable people that do, or those people that do questionable things, they may have been victims themselves. And it's a vicious circle, you know, the victim of abuse or someone that's, you know, lost and joins a certain group because their anger is misguided and they don't have any real help. And that's not to say that's an excuse for deplorable actions or behavior, but let's just put it this way. Every human being is born an innocent child, and I've said this, you know, before. Something happens from when that child is, something happens and they lose their innocence. Just put it that way. So, all right. So that's really going to do it for that subject, and I'm just going to move on here to some other things. See, you know what? Now that you've had something to drink and something to eat, probably give you a little trim. You look like you could use just a little bit of a haircut. Is that alright? Alright, I'm just gonna promise not to butcher it. I'm not a barber, but yeah, I've watched some videos, so yeah, what's it to it? Been otherwise. Been good? You work? Go to school? A little bit off the sides here. So what do you like to do when you know, you're at school or work or watching ASMR videos? That's cool. course, these aren't the best scissors. Okay, yeah, not too bad. Just cleaned it up a little bit. I know you've probably been expecting that Barber Week series of videos, and I've been debating that ever since I've said it for a number of reasons. One being, I'm not really sure if everyone wants to see a barber video back to back to back to back for a week. Get old pretty fast, but see what happens. I'm not ruling anything out. All right. I have here a box of mac and cheese. Thought it'd make some nice tapping sounds. I don't know if you have any kids. They say that the majority of folks watching YouTube videos are like between 18 and 24 or 25. And that doesn't mean someone who's 24 doesn't have kids. But we don't eat the mac and cheese like this all that often. It's not the healthiest thing. It's loaded with sodium, carbs, and fat, I guess, too. But once a month, once every couple months or so, we indulge a little bit. Of course, when you're a kid and when you're younger, you know, you can eat almost anything. You don't have to worry about it too much. When you get older, you get my age, you gotta start watching what you eat. I mean, you should always watch what you eat anyway. I got my wallet, my little beat up old leather wallet. Make some more tapping sounds. I don't know if you have a bank account. I don't know your situation, but if you have a bank account with money and you have a debit card, here in the United States they have these chips on these debit cards now. I don't know the purpose, because with a point, because these chips and the card readers that you have to use with them seem to make the transactions go take a little longer, because you gotta slide the card in and then you still have to type in, you want cash back, you still gotta type in your PIN number. And then you gotta wait for it to approve, and then you gotta take your card out. Sometimes it makes me think. I know, it's like one of these first world problems, right? But this is how a lot of us do, you know, a lot of people, everyday people, folks here, at least here in the United States, use them. It just seems to make it take longer than using cash. I don't really carry cash with me anymore. I don't know about you, there's hardly anywhere you really need to use cash. Unless you're going to like a festival or some place like that. It's just one of those observations, you know? Sometimes I wonder if technology is really doing us more harm than good, all that. So, I'm going to show you some of our son's books, some of the newer ones that he has, and then we'll go back to some of the older ones in case you can relate for nostalgia purposes, maybe. I think it's reading is very important. I'm not sure if you read. I don't get the chance to read as often as I would prefer or like to, because this is really what I do now. But reading is very important, and we've had our son for about a decade, give it a year or two, you know, more or less, and still read to him every single night. Pretty much every night. There may have been a handful or two handfuls of nights where we haven't read to him, but he loves to read, loves his books. So here's one of the newest books that he picked up. He's had a chance to get some new books at his school. Mary Downing Hans Took. It's a ghost story. This is supposed to be a really good book. A lot of good reviews. Very popular. So, Daniel and his sister Erica didn't want to move to rural West Virginia. Their new home is a rundown old farm surrounded by woods, miles from town. The local kids treat Daniel and Erica as snobby outsiders and frighten them with strange stories about their house and a witch called Old Auntie. Erica withdraws further into herself, holding long conversations with her doll, and their parents grow increasingly unhappy in their new surroundings. At first, Daniel dismisses the tales of the witch and her man-eating razorback hog, bloody bones, as superstitious nonsense. But gradually, he is forced to believe that Erica is in real danger. When Erica vanishes, he knows she's been took, and he must summon all his courage to confront Old Auntie and take his sister back. So, sounds like a interesting book. Looking forward to reading that one, or he might read it on his own. Don't really know. A lot of them he'll read on his own. And then some we read to him. This is A Diary of a Wimpy Kid, The Long Haul. These are great books. A mix of drawing or illustration in this kind of diary format. So, these are a lot of fun to read. I'll tell you what, I'm a kid of the 70s, a child of the 70s, and I don't remember any kind of books like this growing up. We had like the Pokey Little Puppy, these small little kids' books. I can't even tell you if they had young readers' books, but today, there's so many children's books and young readers and young adult books. It's ridiculous. It's great. It's great, though. This is the Enemy Above, a novel of World War II. This was kind of acquired for class purposes. Captain Underpants, and well, this is a whole series of books. It's a mix like at times comic book, at times, you know, both pictures and words. I don't know how else to describe it. This is the attack of the talking toilets. These are great. Another great series of books there. This is The Last Kids on Earth and The Zombie Prey. This is the second book of the series by Max Brallier. I'm not sure how to pronounce his last name. Illustrated by Douglas Holgate. This is great. It's a zombie apocalypse, but with kids or teens. I'm not really sure their ages. This was one of our bedtime stories. The first one was, the zombies are disappearing. This might seem like a good thing since zombies eat your brains, but normal human kid Jack Sullivan is suspicious. He keeps hearing an eerie shrieking noise that seems to be almost summoning the zombies, but to where and for what? Probably foul purpose. It's Jack, his three best friends, maybe the only people left on Earth, and their pet monster Rover are going to get to the bottom of this. Blah, blah, blah. This is a good story because I actually was a bully in here that used to bully, Jack. I can't remember, but then they kind of, he sees errors of his ways, so to speak, and they all become friends. Of course, they're surviving the apocalypse, so probably a smart idea anyway. A lot of interesting these books talk about some serious topics like bullying. And, you know, with me, I've been bullied as a kid, kind of hits home a little bit. But it's great that they address that in different ways. So it's not all just story and fluff and nonsense and silliness. There's some heart in these books. This is The Magic Treehouse. This is where the two little kids have a treehouse. Not too many pictures in this one. But their treehouse is like a time travel machine. So they go different periods of time, traveling through the past. Different adventures like that. Arnold, Little Bells, Frog and Toad. This is a cute little story for kids like around 6 years old, something like that, maybe younger. You can see the how spaced it is and the big words, the lettering. So it's definitely more of a kid's children's book than about a frog and a toad who are best friends. Kind of, you always have some kind of misadventure. Dr. Seuss, not the big favorite of our sons. He wasn't always like, oh, read me Dr. Seuss again. So, and I'm not trying to bore you with our family life at all. This is more just to share with you some of the books in case, you know, you're familiar with them or you've read them or you've had them read to you or you read them to your kids if you have any. One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish. I'm sure you're familiar with Dr. Seuss. So, yeah, always a classic. Yeah, if you give a mouse a cookie, apparently it's been around for 25 years, and I had no idea. I only found out about it, like, about a year or so ago. It's amazing how your life changes when you become a parent. There's, like, it's a whole other world. I never thought I would be a father. And my life is very surreal. My Friend Rabbit. This is a cute little book. It had received the Caldecott Medal. A lot of these books that we've picked out, well, not all of them, but the younger ones for the kids. You can see it's just very, it's illustrated. Not too many words, so you have to tell the story using just mostly the illustration. This is a fun little book. So we try to pick out some books. Not all of them that have to have awards, but if it won an award, then it must be a pretty, you know, good book for a kid. So I'm glad we did. There are some interesting books there that you might not ever think about, you know, renting at the library or, but, you know, the award is just nice to find some books that you might not think about picking up, especially if it won an award, you know, it says something pretty special about it. Not that there aren't good books out there that don't have awards. And of course, with our household being non-religious, we still celebrate Christmas. You know, Christmas is pretty much secular holiday anyway. So this is the night before Christmas. Hopefully there's no glare on that. This is a really beautifully illustrated book. It's the classic Night Before Christmas tale, but a really good illustration. If you like that about your books. And just finishing up here with some other books. Hug, story about a little chimpanzee that gets lost from his mother, can't find his mother, so he goes on a little adventure to try to find her. It's a kid's book. Goodnight Gorilla, about a gorilla who steals the keys from the zookeeper, sets all the animals free, and they end up in the zookeeper's house, sleeping around his bed. Corduroy, this is a classic story. I'm sure you might be familiar with it, about a little bear that comes to life and gets adopted by a little girl who lives in an apartment with her mom. Borreguita and the Coyote. This is about a little lamb that the coyote goes after, and she plays some tricks on him to keep him being eaten and to defeat him. The Day the Crayons Quit. This is a great little story about crayons complaining to their owner. I think it's a boy. I'm not really sure if they actually say if it's a boy or a girl. To a boy, Duncan. And they talk about how they're always used a certain way, or they're not used enough, so they like go on strike. And then just two more books here. Where the Wild Things Are. I don't think I ever had this read to me when I was a kid. A lot of these are really new. Where the Wild Things Are is classic. And David Wisner's Flotsam. This won the Caldecott Medal. He is a great artist. This is there's no words, so you actually have to tell the story yourself about what's happening. But it's beautiful. Beautifully illustrated. So I highly recommend any books by him. He's got one called Flotsam, and then he has another one called Tuesday, which is another great book. Okay, so that's going to do it for that. I want to kind of get, you know, share with you that, give you a little insight into my life beyond what you see normally here, you know, with Margaret or Iggy Manley or many other cast of characters and things like that. And hopefully maybe you remember some of those books. All right, we're going to go on now with just a straight up ASMR session with some different sounds. I think what I'll do is put the lampshade over your head. Is that all right? You don't have a problem with that? All right. You might just end up staring at the lampshade inside for a little bit. There we go. Maybe not. Maybe you're just halfway. There we go. angle it down a little bit. Maybe you might be able to see that right there. And I'm just gonna tap and see if maybe this might sound like rain. Tapping on a, shade roof, I guess. And I hope by now that you are nice and relaxed. Just do this side. Switch over to this side. And I'm going to try to limit my amount of talking that I do here on out, since we're late already, deep into the video. If you're using this to sleep, I don't want to keep you awake. Shave my fingers, brush it, I guess. Just using some circular motions. I think that's gonna do it for the lampshade. Maybe I can work this into a video all its own, just like this. Plastic bag that I was going to put over you as well, over your head, because the plastic would be really somewhat loud and close to your ears, I'm going to avoid doing that now, at least this deep into the video. Okay, let's see, what else do we have? Do have some bunched up crinkly bags, so just use these a little bit. And really, this is just meant to be kind of move from object to object, not spend too much time to terracotta bricks. Try to make some scraping sounds and tapping. And hopefully that's something you enjoy. Everyone's got their different triggers, what works for them and what doesn't. I think for the most part, as long as you are not making any sudden, harsh or abrasive sounds, that almost anything can be enjoyed. At least from my experience, I mean, nothing I don't like. Box of matches. Now, I'm not going to light them, but I'm just going to dig around. So let's just take the cover off. Rubbing my fingers here along the, just moving the matchsticks around. And hopefully this is a sound that you enjoy just as well, or just as much. Up here. One more time. That'll do it for that. Let's see. And have this mason jar. Or is it a bottle? It has these not even sure how you describe the surface of it. It's textured, that's for sure. Makes for some nice tapping sounds. It has a lid, so you can explore those sounds. first, then we have some tapping sounds. I think that's going to do it for our little friend. And I have this roll of twine, which makes for some nice kind of scratching sounds. Last time. gonna do it for the ball twine. All right, thought that we would explore. These latex gloves. I just realized at this point in the video I'm just gonna go from doing this, rubbing the fingers together, see if you enjoy these sounds. Move my hands further away and then bring them closer. And get as close as I can. Just finish up . That'll do it for the latex gloves. All right, let's move on to how about the leather gloves? just try to be quiet, gentle, or I should say delicate as possible. Then we can just focus on the one side. And then back to both sides at the same time. That'll do it for the leather gloves. And of course, what would gloves be in an ASMR video without the monster hands? important, very integral part of ASMR video, well, on this channel. Monster hand, fingernail tap. About some calming monster hand movements. Of course, I don't even know if anyone, if you are still awake. While I do these monster hand movements, monster hand on, monster hand off, monster hand on, monster hand off. Master Miyogi taught me. Allow the power of the monster hands to bring you into a deeper state of relaxation and sleep. You are aware that I have an entire video dedicated to the monster hands, right? You should. Some monster hand sounds. Too much, unlike the leather gloves. Do some monster hand fingernail tapping. just one side. Both simultaneously again. That's gonna do it for all the gloves. Let's see if we can squeeze in a little tissue package here at the end. Some of Old Faithful. Probably invest in two of these tissue packages so I could do them simultaneously each year. This video has been long enough. Wouldn't you agree? So, if you're actually watching or listening up to this point, thanks as always for tuning in. And I hope you enjoyed this different little video, but most of all, I hope it has helped you to relax, unwind, sleep, maybe even with your study or your craft, whatever it might be that be using it for, to concentrate. So I wish you all my best on your own journey in life. And I hope to see you in another video real soon. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.